Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play Banished. We're in our town of Noble Landing here, using the MegaMod. And that is spinning really fast. If you've been watching the Farming Simulator 17 series, you'd know that I just got a new mouse. There we go. That has a DPI switch, so I can switch to different sensitivities for different games. And if I were to move my mouse too quickly a couple moments ago, it would have spun this world around twice real quick. Anyway, we have actually gotten close to a food limit. No, that's not going to work. Let me try this setting. There we go. And, well, actually most of it went away. Now there's still some there. There was a whole pile of yellows right over here, and it went away. Food is set for 75,000. So there they go. Yeah, they're all popping back in again. So, that's weird. I mean, we pulled all those nomads in, and we've got more food than we know what to do with. I could up the food limit again. Let's just kind of glance through storage. I haven't done that in a while. 97%, 100%, 82%, 86. We're getting pretty full on most everything. That one's got a little more space. Another guy over here. Over there. Market over here. Anyway. So it's been a few days since I recorded Banished. And whenever that happens, I've got to really try to wrap my brain around what I was working on. So let's go with some comments. I know Kathra had mentioned that, because I was talking last time about herbs, and that what else can you do with herbs? And I was kind of playing with the idea of the... It's not here. Whoa, that spun too quick. Yeah, I got to use this new mouse. Of this guy right over here. We put him in. Interesting. Do I now have to choose before I can use this? I've got no choices. I guess I'm used to the Colonial Charter version and making it out of different things. So what does this do instead? All right, let me look this over again. Merchants at the trading post. This is not what I was expecting. So let's go here. So we went with this guy. Provides better health for your citizens. Okay, so I guess I need the Colonial Charter Apothecary to be able to make things with things. So we'll do this as well. Yeah, we'll do something like that. Actually, does he have... Well, it moves quickly now. Doesn't really have a storefront, so it doesn't have to be here. So this could be where something's a little bit further off. That's right, pause. There's something I wanted to do. I've got to think about that for a second. Going to have a road right here. So this could be out kind of in this area. That would be fine. Put that one there. What was it? Let me go through my notes here. What did I write down while I was editing the last one? Something about the stables. I wanted the train to come up through this pathway here. So before we built these buildings, I want to move them deeper in. So I think we're going to make a turn right here. Take the train up into here, all the way across, and then out into this way, and to get into this area somehow. So, in fact, that'll give us the chance to put a train tunnel through here. So we can take it up at the upper part here. Yeah, then we can turn, drop down into here for a station. Okay, that sounds like a plan. Tunnel through. Pop down into somewhere over here alongside these pastures. So a train's going to turn up into here, which means this guy needs to move. He is the stable. Stable, let's tear down. And let's rebuild. That was production right there, stable. So a little deeper in. A lot deeper in, actually. We never got over here. There was going to be a stable, and what was the other thing that was going to go in here? Barley farms over here. That's been planted. to run the stable, and what was the other thing? Stable made the domesticated animals, but there was a second building, and I said one's going to go here and one's going to go here. Oh, I'm going to go back and have to rewatch my last episode to see what I was doing. Let's see, any notes? Railroad in front of stable. Yeah, that's the note there. Nothing else is jumping out at me. Let's see, hospital. Both greenhouses don't have to be here. Coffee house is not here. No, no other notes are triggering my memory. Something was going to be built here, and something was going to be built here. So hopefully before the episode ends, I'll remember what they were. But we need the train to go through. Let's build the train first. That's probably the best route to go. So get this going again. I never got to finish that first sentence, did I? Okay, well, we stopped that project. All right. So Cathra had said that herbs could be used to make booze. I thought, really? I didn't know that. So let's head over here and take a look at this. Sugarcane, apple, sorghum, fig, herbs. There it is. So we could save our sorghum a bit and use up some of these 2,000 herbs over here. Makes Crowder liqueur? Crowder liqueur? I'm sure I'm butchering that, but it looks German. I'm going to assume it is, and we're going to make that for a while. When we get down around 1,000 herbs or so, then we'll trigger that back to sorghum. Maybe we'll just cycle back and forth there. All right, so there's that one. And another comment that came in was from Tara Bay, who I was trying to find storage to fit this community here. And she mentioned that along with these houses here, which are Red Ketchup's village housing, is this storage group right here. Storage barns, warehouses, and cellars. And this is version 5 of the MegaMod. And with that, we've got these guys. So they are a matching set. So that's the disadvantage to spreading all of the items out into the toolbars, is you don't know what sets belong to each other anymore. But you don't then have to go and look at sets to find that storage. You can go to storage and find storage. So there's advantages and disadvantages both ways. But here is a barn that would have been great for over here instead. That would have. There's really no advantage to it though now. This is the other one. ...1200 capacity. This one, storage shed was where? This one? It doesn't say the capacity. So we don't know which one is better. It's got a bigger footprint, but that's all we know. Okay. So those were those comments. And there's several more, but maybe I'll remember them as I'm going through here. Let's take a peek at merchants. If I remember right, we stopped looking at merchants last time. And just wanted to get some stuff done. Anything in here that's important? Not seeing anything. Milk? Milk, yeah, we'll say that's important. 2,000. Not that we need food, but milk itself has a use. Oats would have a use for the domesticated animals in the stable, but we don't have the stable going. So, whale blubber. Oh, that's something to... We'll grab onto that quite often. We'll definitely use it. Though eventually we're going to get too much lamp oil to do anything with. Let's say, get out the town lamps and light up every street. Could do that. 4,000, right? Yeah. What do we want to sell besides herbs? Let's go down to the bottom. Now, got to kind of refresh my own memory here. What do we have anymore? Fancy furniture. I know frock coats we're getting low on. 300. Out of 1,500. So it must be survival coats that we've got the most of right now. Are survival in here? They are. Survival coats, you are where? Right there, 1,100. Alright, so, and fancy furniture while I'm out here. F, fancy, zero. Ooh. What about regular furniture? almost 300. So that's rebounded there. Okay, so survival goats for a while. That's good to know. So 15 goes into 4,000. How many times? 250 sounds like a good starting point. Let's see where that is. 3750. Okay, that's all of them. So wine, I would imagine wine is doing well. We haven't used a lot of wine in quite some time. Well, only 2200. I was expecting more, but still, 250 we're trying to get. So that is 31. What do you do? Two more. So one fire bundle, and that'll do it. All right, trade and dismiss you. And you guys have got what for us? Whole components we no longer need. Iron or railroad is going in, so let's go ahead and do that. 200. Copper ore, no. Silver ore, no, we'll hold off on that. We're going to have our precious mines going. So we'll do that. 1,000. And 1,000 sounds like 100 steel tools or 100 spirits. We'll do the 100 spirits. Trade and dismiss. You're done. You have got seeds. There's one or more over there. We got the barley seeds last time. Oats would be good as a backup for the stable. Otherwise, I think we're probably fine. Didn't see them go by there. Nope, we'll pass on you. You. Not seeing anything. No, we're going to pass on all that too. Yeah, dismiss you. Over here, not. And over there, not. Okay, so trading is done for now. I was going to say as another one pulls through, but nope, we actually are empty. Wow. So, what have I been missing? We're out of winter. We're 69,000 food, just like that. Wow. We still have some homeless. We have town lodging in there. Okay. I wanted to get the railroad tracks going. So we're going to make this turn, head up into here. Then whatever space is left is what we'll be using for the stable. So let's do that. So what would that be? Road? Yeah, train, which is the choo-choo mod by Red Ketchup. Tracks, straight tracks, and that's the direction. So I'm thinking that it's going to be hard to see in the trees. Right there is where I want it. Okay, let's see if we can pretty much track this thing. So the space between. I think I'm there. Okay. After a while of doing the same task repeatedly, my nerves start to get fried. Getting antsy, saying I want to do something different now. I don't know how Vapa does this. I think that's far enough ahead to get the sense of what's going on. Okay, so that's going in. Question is, does it leave a red spot? Or, well, I can see the road from here, but we'll see if it actually stops me from building over the top or if it acts like a ghost piece. So, what do I want here? Because it'll build over the roads really easy, which makes me wonder if it acts like a ghost piece. So, which means that if it does, then we could put a building over the top, like a train station rolling right through it. Nope, it does. It gets along with the roads, but it is still acting as a solid object. Okay. So the stable will be... I need it on a road. I guess it could be down here. The idea was to get it close to... Oh, storage. Was that it? Let me think about that. They're going to make it. They're going to drop it off somewhere. They're going to use it. And they're going to store it. Must have been a barn that I was thinking of. Maybe that's what it was. Where does this guy go? I guess he goes there. I'll leave the potential for a double road up there if it turns out to be necessary. Yeah, okay. That goes there. So, another barn. Could be in here. That would be fine. We can put our little road across the railroad track there. Yeah. So, barn. What kind? What's the potential usage? Put one up here. These guys are going to be equal distant from here to there. I think so. So a good sized barn over here. Doesn't have to match that one. That was there because of the railroad. So what would look good over here? Storage. A larger barn. Eventually we're going to get into these guys. Just because I want to see them go in. That one is general. Pretty much everything. This feels like something that should be right here, though. Part of the town. This guy attaches to one side. This guy attaches to another side. Would that look odd over here? You know, it might not, because the railroad's right in front of it. And that could be a railroad kind of a building, too. Let's do that. Now, how would we road into that? I need these trees gone. Boy, I need these trees gone. Okay, let's do that. So, guys, can you give me some space here? I'd appreciate that. And I want to do this sooner than later, so let's prioritize this one. Not the railroad track. Oh, we can't. But we'll get the trees out of there. So we'll do that. So how are we doing otherwise? Food is back, is down to 72. So we're still below the 75. You are... We've actually hit a limit on logs. Whoa. Didn't see that coming. Okay. Well, that's good. 77 laborers. No merchants. Wow. That's odd, too. What is there to be doing? All right, let's head to the list while we're waiting. We want to build the town. We did kind of clear a lot of this out, but we do want to also get a couple of milk pens over here by the farm or the dairy. We do have room for that. And I wanted this road to feed in here to these guys. Okay. That road? Or this road? It probably wouldn't hurt to do both. Except that then takes away some of the potential for the... I guess I can get cow pens right in here. That could work. Now, should that be stone? It probably should. Though you would think you'd have kind of a lazy pathway through here, not a stone road. We could stone up to this point and then break off into a path like these are here. Which we need to fix that one as well. That's why we stripped the trees out of that area. Let's do a stone road through here. So we kind of can't. Well, we can if we raise it up. Okay, let's put a path in here then. Where we can. Something like that. Moves across. Goes to here. he goes to here. Then what? Moves out to there. What's this look like if I do that? I think that looks okay. Yeah. And this is merchant. This is the same thing, right? Yeah. Okay, so that continues around there. Probably should connect across here. It probably should. So let's do that. Let's come out to there. Move that across to there. And then... I guess like that. So that travels along the front. The idea was to take the road back here, though. You know, I'm going to veto that idea. I kind of like it out here instead. Yeah. Let's get rid of that. Yep, we'll do that. Okay. So, road is in. That means that I can ignore these traders and put in domesticated animals. That's food. Cows for milk. Milk pen. Is there any chance it's going to fit in here? Not without some manipulation. But I do want them over here. Okay. Milk will be food. We'll store in any barn in the area or right there. Right there, yeah. All right, let's eliminate these roads here. Like that. Let's go ahead and raise up this area. Like that. And like that. Well, I wish I hadn't done that last one, but too late now. So, clear you guys, clear you guys. So let's do this again. I want the milk pens, food, domesticated, right there, to be here and here. Aimed out this way. Let's think about that. Yep, right there. Right there. Okay. This pathway will continue as stone. How far? Actually, it could carve in one. And then go to there. Let's see. We can't... Actually, it's clear up in there, huh? Okay. Do that. At what point does it transition into this road, though? That's what I'm trying to figure out. That. Back over. The back of this building. Then we'll transition back into that road. Okay. So we'll let that build. What's been happening? Lots of folks are dying. Still, we're in good shape everywhere. Apothecary is in. Let's go over there. That is that one. This is what I was hoping to get. Let's see, that's right here. I wanted to see this drop-down menu. Now, I would have assumed that there were herbs being used at the apothecary, and there aren't. That blows me away. I mean, I get the honey and ginger. All these have medicinal values to them. Certain roots do. Dandelion root is really good for your immune system. So I get this, but you still would think that herbs would be part of this if herbs are used for your health. Interesting. Well, we already have something for roots. We don't have something for bone meal yet. And honey. Okay, we'll do that. And cloth. We are making cloth. All right, we're going to go that route. And we'll hire somebody. That was a merchant. Okay, so with that, we're going to have to boost Well, we'll keep the 2,000. Pretty soon we'll be using those herbs up, and then we'll have room for this. Okay, so that's there. That's done. This was here until we got the milk pens in. We just did, but let's race back over there and mark these guys. Where am I? I'm lost. Here. There I am. So you, I want to see. Build. Okay, crop field. That's going to be the barley. That's over there. Yep, and they're getting there. Sure different from what we saw before. Okay, so you're there. And let's continue the track and a bridge. And then we'll get the storage built in here. Road? Road. Choo-choo. Track. Okay, we're going to stop there. Bridge. A stone bridge. Let's go this route. Like so. You're there. And so I'm assuming I can go to this point. Let's leave it one space short. Make sure there's no there's nothing there that I'm not aware of. And we won't build the rest. Okay, so with that, what was that? Someone was... Oh! Thad the Sailor was keel-hauled for mutiny. Wow. What was the other one that gave us a warning a while back? Old age. Anybody not old age? No, maybe it's more recent. Old age. Yeah, okay. So that's interesting. All right, so storage over here. How do we do that? You... So what? Let's go ahead and put the whole group in so we can see it. What was that? Miner and a cave-in. Question is, what do we do for a frontage road over here? There's no road coming in from this side. Probably now or ever. So it's got to be done from here. The bridge is right over there. Now, why the gap in this? Because there's a crane in there. A pulley system. Okay. Well, let's assume there's going to be a road. Put it right there. Like that. And then we'll put one of these to each side. Or does that go in the middle? No, I don't get the sense it does. But I'm looking at the pathway there that the rope goes through. This one had a path on that side only. Over on the right. So that's going to connect to this one. What does this one do? That's the same thing. So this one is going to be up against the side on the left, which is not going to connect to it. So if we built both of them on the right, then it would look better. I think so. We'll build it and we'll see if you follow my reasoning. It was back that far. So if we put that one there, can we put this one there? I think we can. Yeah, I think the ground will flatten. All right, it's going to look a little lopsided, but that way the boards in front connect. So I'm suspecting that has something to do with it. We'll just have to wait and see. We'll figure out the road afterward. All right, so that's done. Milk pen. We already have one in. We did have some domesticated animals, didn't we? That's right. Okay, you're going in. And let's go ahead and employ this one too. There we go. Because that one is about to be finished. Alright, so that's going to make milk for the dairy, which can now have two workers turning milk into whatever. Cheese what was the description? Dairy, you are here? Gotta think about that. Food. Was that an end a long time ago? I'm not getting any pop-ups because it's interacting with this, isn't it? There we go. So it makes butter, cream, and cheese from milk. All three products get made by the dairy automatically when milk is available. Okay. So Banished does not like to have menus over the top of menus. Kind of freaks it out. So this system is going to be working pretty good now. All right. You're done. What else is going on? Crop field got delayed, probably by telling them to take all those trees down. Food is coming up on 75,000 again, and it's going to be even beyond. Yeah, it is. All right, let's kick this up higher. We'll make it 80,000. But let's get some houses in. So how do we want to do that? I have a worker there. We can have, I think, 10 workers there, a couple there. We are starting to get some jobs out here. We could have two there, two in that one. So 6 workers there. So 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 25. We've got 6 houses right now. So this is probably where we want to be building. What do we want to build with? I thought about taking these guys out. I think I'm going to leave them. Let's actually even do some upgrading. We've got the fancy homewares now, don't we? And we need to get that swapped back over to regular homewares again, too. But fancy homewares, 54 of them. These upgrades require 2. Let's do it. Let's go to the bigger size. That's going to throw a bunch of people out of their homes, so we'll stop there. And then get another one in here. No, we'll stop at that. Let's work with some other similar buildings. I'm sure there's others to choose from that are similar enough to look right in here. So houses. Let's just think about things. Now, small homes look like what? Okay, you're those. Forest. Wooden. Farm. Salt box. Could kind of work in here. Stone. Town abode. That's what we're using here? No, it's not. What are you guys? You're the country house. Country house. There, right? Yeah. Okay. So the town abode is the smaller version of it. I didn't click the right one. Huh. Don't remember it looking like that. What am I thinking of? Country home, large residence. Wasn't the town abode the other colonial charter one? I sure thought it looked different than that. Huh, I'm remembering that wrong. Boston House is way too colorful for this area. Okay. You're the little house, so you're quite a different... I have a similar architecture, but the coloring is quite different. Though that would work maybe out in here. Let's do that there. And the brownish roof is probably good. Okay, we'll do that. And dare I try to get the other one going? I could try. F. That one? The snow. Okay, we'll wait on that. So no more colored roofs right now. Colonial small house. Colonial large house. F. Let's see here. I turn myself for a little bit. Okay. Huh. That would work. Where? There isn't a road right there right now. What do you guys face? You're facing there. Did we put a road in here? We did. That looks like, what, a dirt path? That connects into here. Ah. No, you're supposed to be the stone, the mossy stone road. You know, I've noticed I put roads out recently and they've not stopped everything to go build those roads. So I wonder if somehow that priority that has always overwhelmed everything has been eased a little bit somehow. We have a road there. We don't necessarily need one here. But I think I'm going to have to. And let's say that that is going to be wooded. So let's put in the moss stone in that side. Doesn't have to go all the way to the railroad tracks, though. We could have a road that zips through, you know, in this area. Alright, we'll stop it right there. And on that road now will be house, colonial arch residence. And we've chosen the white one. Let's see, it'll be so there's that one or that. Don't like the barn roof for here. So I think we're at this one. Okay. So there. Our road is there. What would look right? A little bit of a yard. And gotta be careful about this guy here. Yeah, something like that. Okay. Railroad bridge went in, another trader. Stable went in. Okay, you are gonna be using barley. And we'll go ahead and employ you, even though there's no barley at the moment, just to get that done. We've got plenty of laborers, and he will act as a laborer. So, speaking of barley getting done, can we get the barley done? Crop field, 91 or 94. Let's just make sure that there's no doubt that that's our next priority right there. Though, we've got only 15 builders. Okay, there's something I didn't notice. We'll take that up to 30. More merchant. Okay, so these are being built. One more footprint right there. I'll leave that one up to remind us to go back and look. Okay, so these are being redone. Nobody is homeless. No more homeless problem. Now that we fixed the issue over here with these guys being built up against the trader without a dock in between. That was my bad. Everything else is now working. Okay, well, we'll go ahead and take a peek in here. Though we certainly, we're out of room on food again. I almost need to sell some food. Maybe that's something to do. And we're using, are we not using the herbs? Because we're still sitting at 2,000. Herbs. Alright, let's take you up to 2 workers. Glassware. Oh, that may be a problem. Well, no, we've got it. I guess we need to think about more shore houses and another glassmaker. Just to get that system solid. Huh. I was thinking of a shore house over here to satisfy this one, so we didn't have to buy sand anymore. How many sand do we actually have right now? 1, 2, 2 sand, and 4 clay. So 2 sand is not quite enough to run this guy. So 3 sand for him would be enough. So if we could get one more sand nearby. This is actually a road, right? Oh, I took the keystone out of there. And I was going to go back in with the regular stone road. Okay. That's a stone road. That means there's another road here in the middle that's been missed as well. Boy, it's hard to see this in the snow. Yeah, this all needs to be rebuilt. Okay. So, and that needs to be rebuilt. Tell you what, let's do a major stone building operation. Road building. Take you to 50. And let's do some of this and get it finally done after all this time. You go to at least there. Do you... Merchant. And I can't really see the rest. We're not going to do all of them, though this one's probably a major, at least from there to there. Yeah, we'll wait till the snow goes away for the rest. Okay. Houses are being built, and when they are built, crop field. When they are built, then a lot of this food's going to get loaded up into them. That's what I'm really shooting for. Barley at the bottom. And two workers this time. Auto pickup. And farmer, merchant. Farmers are fine. Okay, so that's good. Okay, so now what? Train bridge went in. Okay, so we'll touch this up, then we'll go back to that corner track over there. And I guess we can go ahead and do this for a while. Okay. Merchant. A lot of students. Corner track here. Now, it would make sense that we would do something like this. Yeah, it would. I'm hoping I can just stack these as far as I want. So if we were to do that... Okay, so there. Diagonal off of that. Yep, I can see that. Nope. There it is. And there onto it. Okay. So, there off of this one. Diagonal this way. I think that's the right place. Yep, that looks good. And then... Nope, 50-50 chance and I blew it again. There it is. That ties into that. Alright, that's looking pretty good. Now... What kind of stations do we want where? I've been having folks writing in asking just how do the railroads work. And to tell you the truth, I don't know for certain. I know that... let's just look at this. So this train buys goods with coins. So we'll be able to sell goods and get coins, and then those coins can be taken over to the train to buy other goods from. So Model 2 buys goods with coins. Can be used to store some food. This one will store some goods. This guy will store some materials. This guy... attract nomads to your city. Aha! This one... place at the end... Oh, that's the caboose. Okay, this wagon will shelter the train drivers. Well, that's what a caboose does, yeah. I guess we'll save for decoration then. And then the handcart is only decorative. Okay. Stations sell off your food, textiles, utilities, and... Utilities? Utilities. And materials. Utilities, utilities, utilities. I'm not sure what that would be. But it sells off huge quantities of them. It's like it's a tactic that you use to get rid of massive amounts of storage that you've got in your town when you've got a huge town and you've kind of maxed everything out and just needing to dump thousands of a certain kind of product. So it's going to be kind of awkward, but we could at least get them built and not man them. We will do that. We've got logs and iron, coal, that kind of stuff. So let's put in the materials. Right there. Materials train station in this area. So what does he look like? Let's get out in the water. So I take it the train pulls up against that dock right there. That would make sense. So that needs to be against the track. Right in there. Unfortunately, we can't really see it. Eh, we can see it there. Nope, that's not good. They're using that as a road. Okay, let me see this again. Oh, they're using that as a... They're assuming that your road... Okay. They're assuming... The track is being represented as a road also. Okay. Actually, this needs to be a little further in. We're going to have a train parked in front of it. We'll do that right there. And we want to see that one build. Alright, what has built here? Let's go look at all this stuff. This has gone in. So this is what I was talking about. I thought it would look best to have this guy connect. This guy sitting over here is just going to be, you know, out by itself. I'm assuming that somebody will walk up in here and pull. Well, they could open the doors too. That's true. Could do that. Well, we are... What are we doing? Bringing all of this stuff over because we've opened up a pathway? Oh, they're bringing logs and iron as well as whatever they're carrying. So that one carrying herbs going over there is going to be still have those herbs when he comes back. Okay. That was just a weird way of doing it. Narrow warehouse, this is done. General warehouse, that is done. Colonial large house. Okay, we'll go look at that. Hitting the timing on my episode here. How do we want to road into this? And where's the doors for this one? They're inside, right? Boy, if I could just see. There it is. Yeah, they're inside. So a road needs to go in as well. So that's really not the best place to have put it. This almost needs a crossroad. Well, we'll do it anyway. What's this going to be? And why did we creep out our farm here? George did that on one of the farms too, or one of the pastures. Are we planting? We are. Good. Okay, so we're probably going to get overgrown here in trees. So I would say we're going in with a country path, like that, which does what? Actually, it could go right there. I like that. Yeah, that's good. Okay. So, how do we do on the track? I'm not seeing any gaps. I'm not seeing any track. There we go. That's looking really good. Yeah, that's going to work out well. Alright, so this station is already being... That's not the station. That's over there. Okay. Here's the house. We are out of stored fuel again. Okay, stored fuel. We need to get to that next time. Let me just jot down a quick note right now. Let's get fuel. Underline. We've got plenty of workers now. We should not be having fuel problems. So we need to get that figured out. Even if we got to just toss in all kinds of new buildings and get a new industry going. So that's going. We are rebuilding these guys. And they're done. So let's get these guys upgraded next. And you, apothecary, we're just going to leave you. Do we want a different colored roof? something that stands out a little bit. That says, I'm a doctor. We'll do that. We good for now? I think so. Let's take a quick peek over other things we did this episode. These are done. They seem to be happy. Paths are in around the lake. Okay. We got to get back to building a little town area here for the all of this area. A little small little community. Yep, I think we're going to call this one done. I'm going to quickly record one more episode tonight. And let's park us right here so we can get to these roads while it is late spring. And one question mark, someone doesn't have a job. Okay, no nomads have come in that I've noticed. Hopefully nothing has been missed. Doesn't look like it. Okay, you there. And let's call this one done. This has been Noble Rambler. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you next time. Bye-bye, folks.